Merin loved the sea. She loved the sound of the waves calling to her through her window. She dreamt every night of the mysteries that lay beneath. Her father was a fisherman. Each day he went out to sea, and each night Merin waited at the rocky cliff edge, holding up a candle to guide him safely home. The two of them were poor. Their roof was leaky, and they sometimes went hungry. But as long as they had each other, Merin knew they would be okay. At night, her father sang her songs about his great adventures. He sang of giant leviathan serpents, haunted caves, and a lost city of gold beneath the sea. Merin knew the stories weren't real, but she loved to listen to them. She drifted off to sleep, imagining the wonders of the world below. And her life continued that way, simply and happily. Until one night, her father didn't return. Merin held up her candle at the cliff's edge all through the night, staring out at the empty sea. She shivered in the cold wind as she watched for him all the next day. Her eyes welled with tears as night fell again and there was still no sign of her father. At last, she collapsed into sleep. In her dream, she saw him, trapped deep beneath the sea, calling to her for help. She awoke with a jolt. A desperate and dangerous plan was already forming in her head. She took scraps of metal and wood her father had caught in his nets and pieced them together. She hammered and bolted, she measured and sawed. And before the sun had set, she had built a tiny, rickety, submarine. With trembling hands, she squeezed inside and dove down beneath the waves to search for her father. Beneath the waves shimmered with mystery. Glowkelp bulbs lit up around her as she passed by. Merin spotted some odd-looking old coins. Maybe her father would know where they were from. Flickered and danced on the sea floor, like an underwater fire. Her father once told her about a mysterious, living energy called Tyne. Could that have been a Tyne wellspring? seahorse, made of clockwork gears, darted out of the way as Merrin approached. She wondered who could have built such a curious creature. Merrin approached a glowing scrap of metal and pulled it inside. It was claw-shaped and had a strong magnetic pull. She took out her tools and attached it to a firing mechanism on her steering column. Spotted shock nettles ahead of her. She had to be cautious, as the hostile creatures would attack her on sight. Guardian blocked Merrin's path. She knew it all too well from her father's stories, and she knew it must never be woken. According to her father, the Guardians had been built by ancient undersea explorers called the Fomori. Merrin always thought the Fomori were a myth. Now she wondered if her father's other stories might be true. Ships stretched out in the distance. Was her father's boat somewhere among them? Thank you. The old statue reminded her of her father's lullabies about the brave and beautiful Merrows. She sketched the terrain on a sheet of cartography paper. Her father had taught her that those who make maps are never lost. A huge hermit crab watched Merrin from a rocky ledge. On his back, he carried a vast array of odd-looking treasures. Crab seemed to like shiny objects. Maybe he would be willing to make a trade. Using the materials she bought from the hermit crab, Merrin took out her tools and made a quick modification to her magnetic claw. Giant clams were notoriously picky eaters. Each one seemed to prefer a different kind of treat. powerful current was too strong to cross. Merrin's submarine would need greater thrust before it could go back. Amidst the wreckage of an old Fomori vessel lay an undamaged propulsion device. Merrin bolted it onto the back of her submarine, eager to test out its effects on her lightweight craft. around her. She knew this place from her father's songs. These were the lost ruins of the Merrows. Lantern jellies blocked Merrin's path. Although the creatures could be deadly to the touch, they were very shy and even avoided each other's light. Recovering from a bad dream. For a moment, she thought she had experienced her own death, but it had merely been the time showing her one of the many possible roads ahead. Merrin peered through the windows of the houses, wondering if a Merrow girl once lived there, and if her father had sung her lullabies about the world above. Discovered two glowing lights amidst the scraps of an old Fomori machine. She attached them to the front of the submarine's hull, hoping they would help guide her on her journey. Color darted through the shadows. Was that a Merrow maiden swimming through the ruins? Merrin tried to speak to her, but the Merrow raced away. Razor-quilled pufferfish was not a direct threat, but it steadfastly refused to move out of the way.